Hello students, today we will discuss about grids. So grids are known as the representation of natural structures which gives a specific region or a specific location or specific shape we can easily identify, such as you might have seen about the chessboard is one of the grid application or the grid representation. Nowadays cities are typically arranged on a grids, and the location on the earth we can easily find by its longitude and latitude, which also defines the one kind of grid represent on the earth. So the grid is obnique because they are the most natural way to curve space up into region so that we can identify a specific location. In regular grids, each of these shape is identical and they occur in a regular pattern. Means the grid are the representation of shapes where unique pattern is going to be defined, where it comes in a rectangular or rectilinear fashion, the representation of the grids. But due to their simplicity, regular or rectangular based hexagonal grids are most important. Next, we will discuss about the rectilinear grid. So, what rectilinear grid is? Nothing but the representation of the graph. You might have familiar about the representation of graph, where the piece of cells are representing certain values, or you might going to represent a cell with a specific values with its x-axis and with its y-axis. So the cells are typically defined by a regular spaced horizontal and vertical lines. Three-dimensional grids are formed by connecting regular spaced layers of planar grids with perpendicular line across the layers. Three important components of the planar grids are the vertices, edges, and cell interior. These are the three important component when you are going to represent a planar grid. In that regard, we are going to be discussing about triangular and hexagonal grids. So what triangular grids is going to be represented? It's also called as a triangular lattices. So this is going to be constructed from three sets of equally spaced lines consisting of horizontal row axis. A column axis is 60 degree from horizontal and a diagonal axis 120 degree from a horizontal. This diagram will show you a triangular lattices. These horizontal lines are representing the rows. You can see here rows equal to 0, r equal to minus 1, r equal to 1. These lines are representing the horizontal, where the diagonal are representing the columns mentioning with the c equal to 1, c equal to 0, and c equal to minus 1. Typically this point which will give the idea about its axis from column or row or column. So this point is going to be mentioned as 1 comma 0, that is row 1 column 0, where this point indicating 0 row and 0th column. Similarly, all the shape or all the points which are mentioned in this diagram are representing a certain values corresponding with rows and the columns. And all the diagram you will find is creating a particular triangle which will having the column axis is 60 degree, where the diagonal axis 120 degree from the horizontal. Next is hexagonal lattices. So what hexagonal lattices is representing is the regular shape or a certain shape which will produced or which will get from a triangular lattices. How will get the hexagonal grids from a triangular lattices? You might see in this diagram is that the dotted lines which creating a particular triangle. This also is creating a particular triangle. So how many triangles are going to be represent in one hexagon? It may having a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 triangular lattices which leads or which forms a hexagonal grids, where the hexagonal grids are connected with other hexagonal lattices. So one hexagonal lattice, the sides are connected to the other hexagonal lattice, are again is going to be have the 6. You might going to be see if I going to be check with this hexagonal lattices, its sides are connected to other hexagonal lattices are 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So one hexagonal lattice sides are connected with other 6 hexagonal lattices. So what, how we can represent the hexagonal lattice? It's going to be deleting every other vertex from a rectangular lattice leaves us with hexagonal lattices. The face of lattices are regular hexagonal and each hexagonal is adjacent to the 6 other hexagonal lattices. Here you might able to see about number of lattices or hexagonal lattices are connected with each other, where each lattice the face or the adjacent face is connected with other 6 lattices. Thank you.